What is going on, Company of Heroes fans? This is Reckoner, here to give you a Company of Heroes shoutcast today. We're back on CoH1, and we have an OF matchup. That's right, we got an opposing fronts matchup between Brits and Panzer Elite. So we do have an interesting matchup today, and this isn't just any Brit player, at least not a regular Brit player. This is actually Kaos. He is the CND tournament organizer, and he prefers his vanilla factions, especially Wehrmacht. But today he's going to be playing Brits. I think this is the result of a bet that he made on game replays with Iron Roman. But who is he facing? On the other side, Panzer Elite, it is nothing more than I don't understand English. He's a very good Chinese player who has shown a huge preference for Brits, judging by the, it was the first faction that he manages to get to the first position, and he's been playing every other faction efficiently ever since. We got that Chinese micro here in the house today. But let's just see how he plays Panzer Elite. It's not exactly his favorite faction, but we'll see how he goes. So let's get this game start at 3, 2, 1. Unpause. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Unlike vanilla matchups, OF matchups tend to be very diametric from one another. For example, a US could go for a rifle-centric build, a Wehrmacht could go for an MG-centric build, but in the end, both factions are balanced enough to adopt a offensive posture or a defensive posture. It's all entirely up to the player and their capability of manning their army to be able to counter certain threats in a changing battlefield environment. That's not entirely the case for Brits versus PE. Brits are very slow, immobile, but they have great defensive capabilities, so they have to rely on that kind of defensive posture to adopt a very passive early game and then slowly become more aggressive. For PE, they rely on glass cannon type units, so they have to be very aggressive in order to maintain that early game aggression. And what we see here, it looks like our PE player didn't manage to get the push decap on that munitions. And since he's been spending all that time trying to get that that cheeky cheese going, he wasn't able to manage his resource cap that well. He's going to have to rely on his second Schwimmwagen to take care of that, while the first one is going to be under fire from Kaos's Tommy Tide, which is coming in. The Tommies move slower when they're in unfriendly territory, but they do make it up for that soldier armor and the relatively large squad sizes compared to Panzer Elite's much more small but efficient squad sizes. So we got about 9 models versus, looks like 4 models down. Definitely the Tommies going to win that one, especially with now the officer on the field. So Kaos opts for a rather medium-sized build before lifting his HQ to the ammunition sector. It's usually useful for maps in which you'd expect aggressive Panzer Elite play. Usually the cheese that we saw going down to these right munitions point here. And it did manage to work in Kaos's favor. So he is able to secure the right-hand side while the Chinese player, aka I forgot what his original Chinese name tag was, but we'll just call him the PE for now. The PE player was smart enough to move off after he realized that he's not going to win any engagements in the any early engagement on the right hand side, and decides to go the left hand side where he knows that he's not going to be opposed anytime soon. So that's good on him. So right now we have both players securing their side of the map, and it might either be very aggressive and someone gets killed very fast, or we have some good old trench warfare, which apparently World War II was trying to avoid all this time. But well, some things you just can't avoid. So It looks like the PE player decides to get a tier 2, which, and he's going to follow up with half track, an infantry half track. Now, this can be, this is a very micro intensive strat since CoH1 does not have the best vehicle pathing in any of the RTS games in the world, and your ability to micro your IHT and keeping it alive while keeping its effectiveness on the field is going to be entirely dependent on how well you can micro them. So now he's, the PE player is trying to push Chaos's Brits out of cover, trying to get that DPS down and trying to get that suppression in check. But Chaos is moving more Tommies into the field, but I don't know how it's going to end up. The Tommies are now very low on health. He's going to be forced to retreat off the field. Meanwhile, PE manages to get a good chunk of veterancy for his PGs, and he might get some more damage on that recon Tommy that got stuck in a hedge over there between a hedge and a IHT, rocking a hard place. Yeah, but the PE player is trying to maintain his aggression here. He's trying to cap the home strategic point and try to keep a squeeze on Chaos's Brit here. So in the early game, Brits are usually limited by the lack of squad mobility, so they're usually pushed to one side of the map and clinging onto it while planning for a counterattack, which might be in the form of the field support truck. So his tier 2 is going to be down. Might see a Stort, who's and Storts are very effective versus light vehicle half-track play, mainly because the half-tracks don't have any effective form of anti-infantry unless they get the AT half-track out. But now it looks like we have a mortar half-track. So he's trying to follow the realm of pinning and bombing Chaos's Brits over here, like that we see from that flame nade. But Chaos did kill the half track, and so that's going to set a PE player back quite a bit. And now that the mortar half track is in range of his base, Chaos is going to have to be careful to avoid keeping his Tommy stationary at all times, while at the same time reinforcing and queuing up for that counterattack. So while he is trying to push out, Chaos did get pinned by the suppression fire from the G43 PGs, but the DPS being put up by the Tommies has reduced one of the squads to one model. And so now it's just this G43 and this mortar half track against these two Tommies. But these Tommies are getting very low on health. He might have to be forced off the field unless he kills that G43 squad real fast. But it looks like the defensive bonus. What happened? What did he kill? Oh, I think it was just a medic. Oh, and there was a shrimp wagon mine that he placed near the fuel. So not only was that a smart move, this actually demonstrates to all of us, including to Chaos, what doctrine the PE player went, and that would be tank destroyers. So tank destroyers is really centric on direct attacks, and you need to keep attacking the Brit players, otherwise you're going to lose the momentum and eventually Brit players will be able to overwhelm your AT capabilities. But right now it looks like this infantry half track is in trouble. He's down to around 20% HP, but he's going to manage to retreat in time for him to support for the G43 and the regular PGs to support each other. So this mortar half track is actually putting in quite the work. He's ready now, defensive vet 2. And now we have another infantry half track coming out, and he's following up with advanced repairs. So he's really keeping this IHT build as much as possible into this game. But the problem is those IHTs are real fragile, and if he overcommits to the strategy, he might find himself behind when the Stuarts come out. And there it goes. Do we have we see the second IHT going down? And now we have a third PG going out. He may have to consider getting anti-tank soon, otherwise do we see the captain? Oh, I'm not too sure if we saw the captain. And once the Tommies decide to clump up to try to fight off this IHT, he becomes a victim to that mortar half-track. Let's see what Chaos has in store. So that mine that the P player planted there did in fact kill the captain. Oh no, the captain's right here. What am I doing? So he did get the captain, get the retreat, but that mine manages to immobilize the Stuart. Oh, this is bad for the Stuart. I mean, once it's immobilized, that mortar half-track will have easy pickings. So now all that Chaos can do now is to actually use his Tommies to force off this mortar half-track. Mortar half-track does not have real armor, and now it's being buttoned by this Bren. This could spell the end for that mortar half-track. Meanwhile, Chaos did send his Tommy squad to decap that strat point. And he did, in fact, kill that mortar HT. That's going to be another loss for a PE player. And now we're just fighting over this building right here. PE squad managed to get in, but it's going to be a matter of time before they have to leave that building as well. Right now, I think Chaos is ahead. I just hope that he repairs that Stuart in time. And he should, because now we have a Hetzer on the field. They can make some nasty crushes if Chaos isn't careful. We're down to one health, and that IHT is holding the line, trying to reinforce his PGs as well as keeping his aggression on the field. But now we have a damaged engine. We don't know if the Tommies in the building is able to kill that IHT. Now the Hetzers are taking pot shots at the Stuart right here. It could go down. And it does go down instead. Meanwhile, Chaos is trying to come up with a proper solution for that Hetzer. And that's in the form of the British ATPs. It's not much, and it's probably best used in conjunction with the Bren carrier, but it does force the Hetzer off the field. So that's probably going to be ooh, but he's popped the officer charge for the lieutenant. There's one more. Ooh, and he breaks the button. I think it's because the Bren guns were forced to move or forced to stop firing. Whatever the case, the IHT managed to survive that battle. And the Tommy is still firing away. He's still in that building. But Chaos is being a little mindful of the game situation, and he's instead going for cutoffs. This is very good. He's trying to deprive the PE player of the necessary resources. But since he's gone tank destroyers, he doesn't really need that much fuel at this point in time. The main resource bottleneck is manpower, and you don't really need territories for that. And now after the cutoff, he's going for the Chaos is going for the VPs as well. Ooh, the Hetzer got buttoned. I don't know if this single Piat squad will be able to finish it off. I don't think he's gonna break it. Let me see. Ooh, one more barrage could be it. He does rebuild that mortar half track, and it's now popped an incendiary barrage onto the Tommies. Don't know how much longer they can stay in the area. Ooh, and that's... the Hetzers are really low in health. They're just below 10%. He does go for defensive, so it might be able to buy him some time for him to retreat. And now this oh, and he loses another mortar hatch rack. Oh, but he loses the sapper squad as well. So they traded a mortar hatch rack for a sapper. But the Tommy does manage to recover one of the sapper piets before going down. Shut your gobs and listen. Fortunately, the Brits' veterancy carries on to their officers. So, well, this could be also a bane as well as a blessing as well, since if you lose individual frontline units, that won't matter because the veterancy bonuses are carried on by the officer. So as long as you keep this officer alive, you'll be able to keep the veterancy bonuses alive. It's another difference between vanilla factions and, well, I wouldn't say it's another difference. It's every faction has their quirks and their unique capabilities, but this is one of the mainstays of the Brits, is their ability to carry on veterancy onto their officers. But if you do kill the officer, all the veterancy bonuses that was acquired will be lost. So a huge amount of care must be given for the officer's safety, of course. As soon as this medic station gets enough munitions for that group heal. Meanwhile, it looks like Chaos had a lot of Tommies from that medic station. I think he originally built 3 Tommies, but I think the medic station gave him 2 more Tommies. Ooh. Oh, at least not a single model dropped from that mine, so that's a good thing. But because of that, we have about 5 Tommy squads, and we have a pristine rebuilt sapper squad with Piets. But now he's gonna go for that 17-pounder. It's probably a good choice now that he saw that tank destroyers are on the field. So he's gonna need some really strong AT to counter that Hetzer threat. And we have a Bergetiger from the PE player as well. It's a strange decision, since they can only recover wrecks, but doesn't seem like any of the wrecks were left intact over here, except for that except for probably this mortar hat track over here. It does depend on luck sometimes to get this Bergetiger working as best as they can. It does have that nice advanced repair, but we'll see how effective that'll be as the game goes on. So Chaos is using his one recon Tommy to just harass the PE player, just going around the map, start capping around while he's using his mainline Tommies to continually probe and force a way to get the PE player to back off. Oh, and this mortar half track is gonna go down again. I don't know if he's going to kill that wreckage now that he saw the Bergetiger. He's not doing a good job crushing, and he's in the line of fire of that 17-pounder emplacement. Ooh, and he does kill that mortar emplacement. So, and the Bergetiger might actually go down if he's not careful. Meanwhile, the P player was trying to probe the rear with that Shrek and IHT, but there was a lot of Tommies over there, and they fought him off. Ooh, but he's gone all the way down for double Shrek upgrades from that TD, and that will be able to kill off that 17-pounders in a speedy manner. And there it is. There goes the 17-pounder. Probably he's gonna have to get that IHT out of the area. He does have double defensive fit, which is able to prolong the longevity of that IHT. And that's going to create some problems, especially with double Shreks in there. It becomes a massive clan car of destruction. But now it looks like P player is gonna go down and he's going to use his double shrimp wagons to start recapping around the map. I don't know if the Chaos Tommies know about this, or he just doesn't care. He's just gonna go around, he's just gonna keep decapping as many points as he can. At least until the clown car comes around and starts harassing the hell out of him. We do have a we still have an IHT wreck over here, but it's just too close to Chaos's base for him to recover that in a secure manner. Oh, I was wrong. He actually has two Shrek squads instead of just getting double Shrek. Oh, but he goes for a commando artillery. I don't know if he realizes this. You better get out of there. Oh, and he gets... Oh, and he manages to kill one of the squads. And oh, and he does have double Shrek upgrade, so what am I doing right here? Oh, he should get that Shrek out. He should recover that Shrek. I don't know. He already has two Shreks on one of his PGs, so... It's... I think that that Shrek denial is not gonna happen. That's a huge loss for the PE player right there. Now that Brits have a Shrek, they've got effective AT as well as the veterancy of the officer, which is gonna grant them accuracy and rate of fire upgrade. So let's see what the PE player has. He has he has four PGs now, but only two of them have a Shrek. And I'm not sure if Chaos wants to tech up from here. A Firefly would work well in a situation such as this, but then again, who knows? Do have tier 2, tier 3, and tier 4 out for the PE player right here. So that means either A, he's going to tech to Panthers, or B, he's just trying to react flexibly to whatever Chaos is planning to unleash onto him. But it looks like Chaos is planning for a defensive aggressive playstyle. He's going to stick to the right hand side, which is beneficial for him because it has two VPs points on this side and only one VP on the left hand side. So as long as he holds on to this side and as well as these two VPs, he's able to win the VP war in the end. Meanwhile, it does appear that the PE player did go for Panthers, and he's unlocked the Panthers. He's just waiting for the manpowers to summon them onto the battlefield. But Chaos did rebuild his 17-pounder, so he's probably going to be ready for what... He's trying to be ready for that inevitable armored spearhead that the PE player is going to send in his way. He can't wait out this game for too long, since he is on the disadvantageous on the left-hand side with only one VP. So eventually, he's going to have to secure at least one of the VPs or go for the jugular and knock out his entire base altogether. With his double Shreks, he is able to neutralize the base in a timely fashion. So he is taking out the base MGs here, which might put a stranglehold onto his onto the rear of him. He is able to clear both of the MGs out. The Hetzer's dueling with the sappers and the Shrek and is losing badly. Oh, and now with the Brens coming in, this could be a nasty button. He does indeed get the button. The sappers might be able to get some nasty rear shots along with this Panzer Shrek, and it does kill the Hetzer. Meanwhile, The PE player is going for a base rape session. Now with double Shreks, he's going to go around. He's trying to destroy as much of the base as much as he can. But he's turned his 17 pound around to try to target that IHT. He does manage to get out there, but I don't know how much longer he can live against that Shrek, Tommy. And this Burger Tigger seems to be a little out of place here. The IHT does go down. He's forced off the field. We got another VP run for one of Chaos's Tommies. And now we got... Ooh, that was a good mine hit. That's four models down, but... But this Burger Tinker might go down. He's seen better days. Oh, but he's tanking all those shots. He's still alive, but I think he's going to be backed into a corner really soon. Oh, he takes another shot. He takes another button. Zappers are probably going to go around for that rear armor hit, but it fails again. He should probably get that Zapper, that Tommy squad around for that pincer movement, but he gets the Zappers around, and this is the end for the Burger Tiger. But the Panthers are in. He could go into his base. I don't know if he's in a crushing mood. He could go in and he could crush all of his Tommy squads up here, but he should be aware that the 17 pounder has come around. But it doesn't matter because he's moving in his Shreks around to deal with that 17 pounder. Panthers are at the entrance. They're at the gates. The medic station has gone down, so he's trying to buy some time to get that to keep that Vet 3 LT around. Alive while keeping his Sappers and Shrek Tommies alive as well. So now it is Chaos who is in the corner here against these two Panthers and he retreated the Shrek Rendeers. So it looks like Chaos's only hope. Oh no, why are you turning around? Why did you just turn around? I don't know if the heroic charge is going to run out. It could run out here. Oh, but no, he snags one of the Panthers. And now it's going to put him in the jaws of that AT blob. Not a good play by the PE player right here. He does lose one of the shrimp wagons from one of the harassing Tommies. Oh, but he actually breaks the button and he might actually escape from that. I think the Shrek Tommy is just out of range from that shot. And the Sappers, well, they don't really have much luck versus moving targets. Oh no, watch you turn around, watch you turn around. Keep backing up. He shoots one more shot. This is the end for the Panther. Oh no. You could have been spared by all that if you just backed up. Oh, but meanwhile, it looks like the PE player has gone in for another Shrek run. This could be the end for that HQ right over here. And without a structure, this is an annihilation victory. But is it? Oh, he manages to get his command truck out just in time before that... But for the annihilation requirements set in. You feel it, Kampkopper. We have the zeal. So now it looks like the PE player is now designed to upgrade his PGs with zeal. They're going to perform much better when they're surrounded by their PG brethren. Which, of course, means that PGs will have to blob to be more effective. But at this point in time, it's Tommies have to perform effective when they're next to a officer. So it's pretty much a blob on blob war now. Do have these brave Tommies with their Lee Enfields trying to challenge this Krupp Steel. But I think they're just going to call it a day. Yep, they're going to retreat. Oh, but the command truck isn't down yet. We'll be down now. And he's going to retreat them again back to that HQ. So it's this one lone Panther going to chase down these Tommies, but he's got to be careful because this could be a trap for the Panther. That's right. Don't keep going. Oh, you see this? You see the Tommy, which means there could be more Tommies and at least some more Shreks and Piets. But we got a commander going down here, and it's just these commandos versus these Shreks. So I guess eventually they're going to kill one of the squad members, and it looks like the commandos are going to lose this battle and their lives. Oh, but he manages to smoke camo camouflage out there. Meanwhile, this Panther does in fact go down. I don't know. He's playing very risky with his Panther now. You shouldn't really charge into the Brit HQ, especially when you know that he's got a sizable AT, sizable AT complement. But he does see this Shrek mob coming in. And he does retreat the squads just in time. He smokes the commando again to try to keep him alive from getting sniped from one of them. But they're now between a trench and another blob. He does throw those incendiary nades down, but with only Shreks on the field, they're not able to stay on that field for much longer. So now the P player is now extending his PG complement to include MP44s, but he's going to need a lot more than just one MP44 squad to stay on the battlefield. Especially with a Vet 3 LT. He does lose, I think, that G43 squad, which is going to give him more trouble than before. He has a heavy anti-vehicle capabilities, but he has basically no anti-infantry. Meanwhile, this is going to prove very dangerous for the PE player in this VP war. Ooh, he does spot one of the mines. It's from this recon set, Tommy right over here. He does place a demo charge. I don't know if the PE player was able to spot it in time. He does spot it. But now this VP war is proving to be disfavorable for the PE player. He's down to 44 VPs, and it is ticking down fast. It's 1 white, 2 reds, at least 2 in favor for Chaos right here. What is he doing? Is he going for another Panther battle group? I don't know if Panthers would be the best choice in this scenario. I mean, I guess he's begging for strong vehicles to hold the line, but unless he's able to deal with that button or that AT blob in general, he's unable to do much with his Panthers at this time. Does place another mine down. I guess he's going for he's hoping to win by another round of base annihilation. He's trying to flush Tommies out of that trench over there, but the AP blobs are back again. I just hope that there is some way for the PE player to detonate that mine. He could go for the crush. He does annihilate that Tommy squad, but the crush could have gone a lot better than it is going on right now. That's one. I don't know if he can get another one. Come on, kill the Tommy. There it is. He breaks the button from that Bren by pushing them around. I think he lost some He lost the Schwimmwagen and trying to recap his fuel VP, but it looks like the VPs are going to go down regardless. And that is game. It's rather unfortunate that the P player was unable to finish Chaos off when he had the chance. And if he kept that remaining, if he kept his Panthers alive, he would have been able to have this game in the bag. But unfortunately, it went to Chaos for... Yeah, I mean, I think that Shrek Squad was that Shrek drop gave Chaos the edge over the tank battles between, well, I wouldn't really call it a tank battle, but really to counter the P player's Panther Blitz when he does try to go in and attack him. So who knows, maybe if the P player invested a little bit more in anti-infantry rather than putting all of his eggs in one basket for anti-tank, he may be able to have this game in the bag. But then again, he, knowing himself, he probably knows a few tricks about Brits since he's an avid Brit player as well, and I think he does like his stag spam. In that case, it would make the anti-tank investment, the heavy anti-tank investment, understandable from that angle. But unfortunately, it didn't happen, and he was unable to counter the massive infantry force that Chaos amassed. So that is our game today. I thank you all for watching, and if you all want to watch more games or want to see me cast more replays, just let me know, and I hope you enjoy this and hope to see you all next time. As always, Eagle 6 out.